Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's compare Apple's new MacBook Air with the new iPad Pro. MacMost is supported by more than 600 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So Apple's recent announcement included two products that really compete with each other. There's the new MacBook Air, the lowest end MacBook and sure to be their biggest seller among all the Macs in the next few months. And also the new iPad Pro, which is soon going to have a companion Magic Keyboard that brings not just a full keyboard but also a trackpad to the iPad. So that makes the new iPad Pro with the Magic Keyboard basically a laptop, which means that the MacBook Air and the iPad Pro now compete directly with each other. If you want a new Apple laptop at about the $1,000 range, you need to decide between the MacBook Air and the iPad Pro. So since the iPad came out, people have been asking if you can use it as a laptop replacement. Now that the iPad Pro is relatively powerful, has a keyboard and a trackpad, and a great set of Apple and third-party apps that you can get for it, the comparison is more legitimate than ever. Whether you can use an iPad as a laptop is always very subjective. It really depended on what you need to do with your laptop. But now there are going to be more people than ever that could go with an iPad Pro over a MacBook Air. The question is, should you? So let's start by taking a look at the basic specs. If you try to compare the two as pieces of computer hardware, they actually come pretty close to each other. So I'm going to compare the base model MacBook Air at $999 with the base model iPad Pro at $799. Now of course you can get better versions of both of them, but I needed something, some basic level to compare them at. So it looks like the iPad Pro is cheaper, but you're going to have to spend another $300 to get the Magic Keyboard with it to make it a real laptop. So in fact the iPad Pro option is $100 more. Tech specs are very similar if you look at them. Similar screens. The processors are pretty comparable. The RAM's pretty comparable. But you do get twice the amount of storage on a MacBook Air that you do on an iPad Pro. You're going to have to spend a little more to get the same amount of storage in your iPad Pro. Battery life is kind of important for a laptop, and these have similar battery life, although the MacBook Air might have an edge here. I mean, that 11 hours is including, of course, the keyboard and trackpad. The 10 hours is without it, so you may have a little less. But of course, it's pretty impressive considering the battery takes up a lot of the weight of either one of these. You can get better battery life with half the weight and half the thickness on an iPad Pro. Now, I don't know what the exact final weight or thickness of a MacBook Pro is because we don't know that for the Magic Keyboard yet. But we can guess that you're still going to end up with about half the weight and about half the thickness if you go with the iPad. For a lot of people, this is like the most important aspect of a laptop, the weight. I know there are people in two camps, right? People that think that weight really doesn't matter. Who cares about that? What's the power? What's the specs and all of that? And other people think that weight is like the most important thing because they got to carry this thing around all day at school or at their job or whatever. So if weight's important to you, the iPad Pro has a huge advantage. Now when you look at the AV accessories with each one, there's something really interesting here. The iPad Pro, of course, is a camera. I mean, it comes with a 12 megapixel regular wide angle lens, a 10 megapixel ultra wide lens, and it also has a camera on the front facing you that's a 7 megapixel one. You can do 4K video with the cameras on the back and 1080 video with the cameras on the front. The MacBook Air really doesn't have anything. I mean, it's got a 720p FaceTime camera, really just for FaceTime. You're not going to take pictures with it. You're not going to record video with it. So the iPad Pro can be used as a camera, can be used to record video. For a lot of people, that's a huge plus, and the MacBook Air has really nothing on its side to compare. Also, when you look at speakers and microphones, the iPad Pro has an advantage there too. The MacBook Air has the Touch ID button on it, so you do have the ability to quickly log in and use passwords with that. On the iPad Pro, you'll be using Face ID. So you have two comparable security technologies there. The MacBook Air has two USB-C ports, whereas the iPad Pro only has one. And of course, you can do more with the iPad Air's ports because they're Thunderbolt ports. So compatible with a lot more devices. And there's also a headphone jack on it too. So here's some miscellaneous features. The MacBook Air really can be used as a portable machine that then you dock with an external GPU These run from $400 to $1,000+, and then you can have a whole bunch of screens plugged in and get a whole bunch of extra power through this external GPU. You can't do that with the iPad. There's some little features of the iPad Pro. There's the new LiDAR scanner, which is, you know, for 3D objects and augmented reality. There's also the accelerometer and gyros in it. That's the same stuff we have on our iPhones and all, you know, so you can play games and do things, and it knows how you're holding the phone and how you're moving it. But really the big extra is the multi-touch display. If this is something you want, the MacBook Air has nothing. Whereas the iPad Pro, of course, even if you're going to use the keyboard and the trackpad, you still have the touchscreen display to be able to do other things with it. You can take the keyboard off and still use the touchscreen display like a regular iPad. And then you can go further with that. If you buy an Apple Pencil, now you have a precision tool for graphic artists. So far this sounds like the iPad Pro is the better deal for just about everything. But here's where the MacBook Air shines. You've got two different operating systems. Mac OS for the MacBook Air and iPad OS for the iPad Pro. If you try to compare the app stores, it looks like the iPad Pro wins too, because there are like 2 million plus apps in the iOS app store, whereas you only have maybe 30,000, I don't know, 40,000 apps for Mac OS. But this is really kind of misleading, because first of all, how many apps do you really need, right? 10, 20, 30 different apps to get all your work done. If you have all those, who cares how many millions of apps there are in the store that you don't need? A lot of the apps for iOS are games and duplicates of existing apps and things like that. But back to the operating systems. The thing that really makes MacBook Air shine is Mac OS. It's still just very superior to iOS, especially when you're thinking in terms of using a laptop. First, there's better multitasking. I mean, there's no way around it. iPad OS has some good multitasking now, right? You can split screen, you've got overlays, you can easily switch between apps, but it's still not pro level multitasking that you get with a regular operating system where you can have multiple windows and arrange them like you want. And even though there's fewer apps for Mac OS, there's probably the ones that you actually need to get work done, right? If you need video editing apps, you really need Mac OS. There's stuff in iPad OS, but the Pro tools are really going to be for Mac. Same thing for a lot of graphics stuff. Definitely for developer tools, whether you're developing apps or whether you're developing websites, working on servers, things like that, you're going to have an advantage using Mac OS. Apple's own tool, Xcode, which is used to develop both Mac apps and iOS apps, only works on the Mac. It's a Mac tool. So you can't even create iPad apps on the iPad. You have to do it on a Mac. And also, if there are specific apps that you need to use for your profession, chances are they're probably on Mac OS, not on iPad OS. Of course, this varies, and you just need to basically take an inventory of what you really need to do on your laptop. If everything you need is available as an iPad app, or you can do it in the web browser, then maybe you're fine with the iPad Pro. But if there's some critical tool that's not available for the iPad, well, then the decision is made for you. And also keep in mind that you can go outside of the App Store with Mac OS. So you can download all sorts of open source apps, apps for very specific purposes, things like that. You find that in Mac OS, but you won't find that on the iPad because everything has to go through Apple's App Store. On the other hand, on the iPad, it's easier to learn. So if you're not a techie and you want something easy to learn, it's much easier to learn how to use iPad OS than it is to learn Mac OS. And also the same for apps, right? Apps tend to be simpler, more self-explanatory. And also don't forget, there are some things that just work inside of apps, lots of social networks, lots of photo sites, things like that, that you have to go through an app to do it. They don't even have like a website or something. So in that case, it's a little advantage to have an iPad. And with gaming, you're going to have a lot more games on the iPad, but they're going to tend to be casual games. More hardcore games, you're going to find some on the iPad, but mostly on the Mac. Of course, if you're really into hardcore games, you're probably using a PC or more likely something like an Xbox or PlayStation. So if you're a hardcore gamer, you're probably not buying either one of these. So if it's weight that you're interested in, the iPad wins. If it's power, the MacBook Air wins. If you need something that also works as a camera, the iPad Pro wins. And it also wins if you want the touchscreen. But as far as apps are concerned, the iPad Pro, of course, has a lot more available, which is a big advantage, but the Mac has more Pro tools. So what's the right answer? Well, there is no right answer. If one of these was clearly better for everybody, Apple would just make that one and not make the other one. I could definitely see some people that have a desktop Mac, like an iMac, getting an iPad Pro with a keyboard and using that as their portable machine. And that way you have access to the best of both worlds. But if there's a Pro app that's only available on the Mac, you can't get that on the iPad Pro, well, then you're going to have to go with the MacBook Air. The iPad Pro just still isn't an option for you, at least not as your only portable machine. Let me know what you're thinking. Is the iPad Pro now a legitimate laptop replacement? Which one of these is the better low-end portable solution for Apple users? I publish new tutorials every weekday. hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.